God's Mercy, 470 in the blue hymnal.
As soon as people start singing vocal. If you want, sure. Blessed be the one holy and living church and living God.
Glory to God forever and ever.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Glory, glory, hallelujah, Lord, we praise your holy name. Glory, glory, hallelujah, Lord, we praise your holy name. Glory, glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Glory, glory, hallelujah, Lord, we praise your holy name. Glory, glory, hallelujah, Lord, we praise your holy name.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, it is only by your gift that your faithful people offer you true and laudable service. Grant that we may run without stumbling to obtain your heavenly promises through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
Our first reading is a reading from Isaiah. Hear the word of the Lord, you rulers of Sodom. Listen to the teaching of our God, you people of Gomorrah. What to me is the multitude of your sacrifices, says the Lord? I have had enough of burnt offerings, of rams, and the fat of fed beasts. I do not delight in the blood of bulls, or of lambs, or of goats. When you come to appear before me, who asked this from your hand? Trample my courts no more. Bringing offerings is futile. Incense is an abomination to me. New moon and Sabbath and calling of convocation, I cannot endure solemn assemblies with iniquity. Your new moons and your appointed festivals, my soul hates. They have become a burden to me. I am weary of bearing them. When you stretch out your hands, I will hide my eyes from you. Even though you make many prayers, I will not listen. Your hands are full of blood. Wash yourselves. Make yourselves clean. Remove the evil of your doings from before my eyes. Cease to do evil. Learn to do good. Seek justice. Rescue the oppressed. Defend the orchid, the orphan. Plead for the widow. Come now, let us argue it out, says the Lord. Though your sins are like scarlet, they shall be like snow. Though they are red like crimson, they shall become like wool. Let us hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
We will read a portion of Psalm 32 responsively. I will begin. Please respond after the asterisk. Happy are they whose transgressions are forgiven,
whose sins are put away.
Happy are they to whom the Lord imputes no guilt,
and in whose spirit there is no guile.
While I held my tongue, my bones withered away.
With a long moaning all the day long.
For your hand was heavy upon me day and night.
Right up as in the heat of summer.
Then I acknowledged my sin to you.
Did not conceal my guilt.
I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord.
Then you forgave me the guilt of my sin.
Therefore, all the faithful will make their prayers to you in time of trouble.
When the great waters overflow, they shall not reach them.
You are my hiding place. You preserve me from trouble.
Surround me with shouts of deliverance.
Our second reading is a reading from Paul's second letter to the Thessalonians. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, to the Church of the Thessalonians in God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. We must always give thanks to God for you, brothers and sisters, as is right, because your faith is growing abundantly, and the love of every one of you for one another is increasing. Therefore, we ourselves boast of you among the churches of God for your steadfastness and faith during all your persecutions and the afflictions that you are enduring. To this end, we will always pray for you, asking that our God will make you worthy of his call and will fulfill by his power every good resolve and work of faith, so that the name of our Lord Jesus may be glorified in you, and you in him, according to the grace of our God and the Lord Jesus Christ. Let us hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Our gradual hymn is the beautiful, softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling, because our gospel story is the story of Zacchaeus. It's called, Come On Down, I'm Going to Your House Today. It's in the insert in your bulletin.
Thank you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through it. A man was there named Zacchaeus. He was a chief tax collector and was rich. He was trying to see who Jesus was, but on the account of the crowd, he could not, because he was short in stature. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore tree to see him, because he was going to pass that way. When Jesus came to the place, he looked up and said to him, "Zacchaeus, hurry and come down, for I must stay at your house today." So he hurried down and was happy to welcome him. All who saw it began to grumble and said, "He has gone to the guest of one who is a sinner." Zacchaeus stood there and said to the Lord, "Look, half of my possessions, Lord, I will give to the poor. And if I have defrauded anyone of anything, I will pay back four times as much." Then Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, because he too is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek out and to save the lost." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
You may be seated. In the name of God, the Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer. Have you ever been to a parade where you couldn't see past the person in front of you? Perhaps the person in front of you was too tall or maybe too wide, so you couldn't see the marching bands, the prancing horses, or the fire trucks flashing their lights. When you were then hoisted up on the shoulders of your father, grandfather, perhaps your mother, you were able to clearly see the parade, the bands, the horses, and the fire trucks. In today's gospel, we come upon another kind of parade, where short little Zacchaeus couldn't see past all the people in the crowds. He wanted to see Jesus, but he had to climb a tree in order to see him. I'd like to offer a little background to help us visualize what's happening in this particular story. It's taking place near what we would call today a toll booth on the road through Jericho. There were two major roads in Israel at that time, and one of them went through Jericho. Between the two cities were Palestinians or Samaritans who were hostile enemies towards the Jews. Jericho was the customs station, and thousands of Jews came through there and had to pay taxes on every cow, calf, and camel. It was Passover, which meant that tens and thousands of Jewish pilgrims coming down. There's a little bug up here, so I'm just going to cover him up a little bit. I think he wants to listen, too, to what's going on here. I don't want to go towards Samantha. Did it go away? It was Passover, which meant that tens of thousands of Jewish pilgrims were coming down from Galilee, going around Samaria, because it was unsafe going through that particular area to pay taxes. Researcher tells us that 2 to 3 million people showed up for the Passover. I was a little surprised to hear that, but I can just imagine what that was like. Tens or millions of people just all gathered together. Jesus was also making this trip from up north in Galilee, coming south through Jericho towards Jerusalem. Jesus had become pretty popular, raising Lazarus from the dead, healing the blind man, and turning the water into wine. So tens and thousands of people passing through customs wanted to see Jesus because of his popularity. Zacchaeus ran ahead and cleverly climbed a sycamore tree and waited. We really don't know how long he waited. The tree he climbed was a sycamore tree, which is like a fig tree, but taller. It's about 50 to 75 feet tall and about 50 feet wide. It has large leaves like a maple or an oak tree. Well, let's pause here for a moment and talk about who the Zacchaeus really was. We get a little picture of that in the gospel today. He was the most despised man in Jericho, a crook. He not only was a tax collector at the toll booth, he was the chief tax collector. He was the richest man in town who worked for the Roman government, collecting their taxes. He also helped himself for his own personal gain. He was a thief, a con man, but untouchable because he was protected by the Roman government. So why was Zacchaeus so desperate to seek Jesus? I think the important question for today here is, why do you or I seek Jesus on any given Sunday? I'm sure it's not all about the goodies in the church hall after the service. Though I must say, we do have some very nice goodies on any given Sunday. I want to take us back to last week, Sunday. As I listened to Reverend Esther, I wrote down a few notes from her sermon, which I feel are central to today's gospel message. Here are a few things that she touched on. We are formed by our interactions. Love one another, even in difficult relationships. And ask God to work in us through faith so that we may be shaped into better Christians. To tag on to Reverend Esther, I want us to focus today on the message of increasing our gift of faith by asking God to work in and through us. Let me repeat that. Increase our gift of faith by asking God to work in and through us. Having said that, I recently came across an interesting article worth sharing where the Catholic Church is promoting a national Eucharistic revival. Maybe some of you have heard of that. They began advertising this year on June 19th to restore an understanding of devotion to the Eucharist that will enkindle a living relationship between us and Jesus. Their focus, as well as the Episcopal Church, is that our world is hurting. We are all in need of healing, and yet many of us are separated from the very source of our strength. Jesus Christ invites us at every opportunity to return to the source of our faith. Many of us here come from other faith traditions before coming to the one and only true church. At least, that is what I was told when I first came to the Episcopal Church. And probably the reason why I began our service with, instead of Christ, I said church, because it is, as I've heard, the one and only true church. And they added, without the guilt, there's not a lot of guilt in the Episcopal Church. Our goal as a church is to seek how we can be in a personal relationship with God. And one of those ways happens the very moment that we partake of the mystical body and blood of Jesus, where God's grace is given to each and everyone's freely. Anglicans, that's who we are as Episcopalians, generally and officially believe in the real presence of Christ in the Eucharist. Though the bread and the wine are unchanged, the communicant receives the sacrament in remembrance of Christ's sacrifice, revealed through a mystical experience, graciously given by God and a work of the Holy Spirit interacting with human consciousness. We say these words every Sunday in our post-communion prayer. Thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food and for assuring us in these holy mysteries. I believe that is what Zacchaeus was seeking, a deeper and more personal relationship with Jesus. And it happened while dining together at Zacchaeus's home. In his encounter with Jesus, he was changed from being greedy to generous, from selfish to selfless, from a thieving heart to a thankful heart. He had a change of heart in the level of financial generosity, where he had only to pay back what he stole, but instead he wanted to pay back 400%. According to Old Testament law, he didn't have to do that. He wanted to. In a few weeks, we will experience what it means to wait, somewhat like Zacchaeus, when we enter into the season of Advent. The heart, throughout history and across almost every culture, is believed to be where our home lies. It is the deepest dwelling of our physical and yet spiritual being. And all we need to do, metaphorically speaking, is to come down from whatever tree or branch we are sitting and waiting on and let Jesus in. And we do it by faith. Amen. Now, please stand and let us profess our faith through the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made flesh. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. Father and the Son, he worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people. God of mercy and love, we bring before you the needs and concerns of the world around us as we say, hear our prayer, O Holy One. For the Church especially for Michael, our presiding bishop, and Jeffrey, our bishop provisional, Esther, our priest, and all priests and deacons, that we may be worthy of God's call to good works in the name of Christ.
Hear our prayer, O Holy One.
For St. Aidan's, that this parish family, that like Zacchaeus, we may run with haste to welcome Christ into our hearts and lives. Hear our prayer, O Holy One. For our country and all its citizens who are bound together in common life, that divisions may crumble, suspicions disappear, and hatred cease, and that all may live together in justice and peace. Hear our prayer, O Holy One. For the people of Ukraine, that they may be delivered from their death and destruction of war, and be strong in the hope of their cause.
Hear our prayer, O Holy One.
For all who are small in spirit and unable to see Jesus, that they may hear God's call and know that they are welcomed and loved.
Hear our prayer, O Holy One.
For the lost, those seeking forgiveness and welcome, and for all those in need of our prayers, that they may be nurtured and fed by God's abundant love.
Hear our prayer, O Holy One.
For all the departed, that they may be welcomed into the eternal joy of heaven.
Hear our prayer, O Holy One.
In the communion of all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord, our God. Let us continue to pray for peace for the world, especially the war between the Ukraine and Russia. We pray for the families of children affected by RSV across the country. I lift up each and every one of you, each and one of us, in prayer for those loved ones that are being remembered on the ofrenda. We pray for those in the military contemplating suicide, that they would be healing of mind, body, and spirit. We especially pray for Sean. I now invite your prayers, either said out loud or in your heart. We lift up to you Jonathan Marsh and LaMercy Marsh. In our diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for St. Francis House Episcopal Student Center. In the Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for La Iglesia Anglicana de Chile. Gracious God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Creator Christ and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. And now let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all of our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Thank you.
needs.
Okay, I know that we have several birthdays. I'm not aware if there are any anniversaries. Okay, so birthdays. Today we are remembering Reverend Esther Kramer. I'm sure that she is away and I'm glad she's able to take some time for herself. And the other is Bert Mendoza and Dennis Daly. Daly. And where is Dennis? Is Dennis here? Dennis, okay. All right, so you could stay where you are, you could come up forward, and we'll just hold a place for Esther. You have a birthday too? You do? You have a birthday? Oh, why didn't we get your phone here? Okay, I suppose we have another birthday as well. Oh, so why don't you turn around, Addison, for Addison. Okay, so on the back of your booklet, let us pray the birthday prayer. Okay. Oh God, our times are in your hand. Look with favor, we pray, on your servants as they begin another year. Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace and strengthen their trust in your goodness all the days of their lives. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Happy birthday. Now, do we have any announcements?
Well, that is a want, and my maintenance budget mainly takes care of needs. And so we kind of think we over the farm, and after thinking about it, we come up with a compromise. And that would be that the best we would start taking the floor project by putting in $1,000. And anyone who would like to support that should let me and my wife know. The cost estimate that we got to do for an internet system to be standing down to put another service spot is $3,200. And our group here is above that. So that's why we kind of down a need for one. And it isn't in the need column, in the want column, but it is a need for a bonus.
Anyone else? Today after the service, please join me outside of the sacristy here for a blessing over the ofrenda before we go into for coffee hour. So join us for coffee hour as well. All right, so let us walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God.
We continue with your insert singing, Jesus, Lover of My Soul. Please rise.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and service.
God of all power, ruler of the universe, you are worthy of glory and praise.
Glory to you forever and ever.
At your command, all things came to be. The vast expanse of intercellular space, galaxies, suns, the planets in their courses, and their fragile Earth, our island home. By your will, they were created and have their being. From the primal elements, you brought forth the human race and blessed us with memory, reason, and skill. You made us the rulers of creation, but we turned against you and betrayed your trust, and we turned against one another. Have mercy, Lord, for we are sinners in your sight. Again and again, you called us to return. Through prophets and sages, you revealed your righteous law. And in the fullness of time, you sent your only son, born of a woman, to fulfill your law and to open for us the way of freedom and peace. By his blood he reconciled us. By his wounds we are healed. And therefore we praise you, joining with the heavenly chorus, with prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all those in every generation who have looked to you in hope to proclaim with them your glory in this unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest.
And so, gracious God, we who have been redeemed and made a new people by water and the Spirit, now bring before you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord. On the night when he was betrayed, he took bread. He said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, gave thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering now his work of redemption and offering to you this sacrifice of thanksgiving, we celebrate his death and resurrection as we await the day of his coming. Lord God of our fathers and mothers, God of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Hagar, Sarah, Rebecca, Leah, and Rachel, God of our Lord Jesus Christ, open our eyes to see your hand at work in the world about us. Deliver us from the presumption of coming to this table for solace only and not for strength, for pardon only and not for renewal. Let the grace of this holy communion make us one body, one spirit in Christ, that we may worthily serve the world in his name. Risen Lord, be known to us in the breaking of the bread. Accept these prayers and praises through Jesus Christ, our great high priest, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit, your church gives honor, glory, and worship from generation to generation.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we now pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
And oh God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The 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 bread of heaven. The body of Christ, 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 the bread of heaven. bread of heaven, the body of Christ, the bread of heaven, the body of Christ, the bread of heaven, the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Body of Christ, the bread of heaven, the 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 body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The bread of heaven. The body of Christ, 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 the bread of heaven. And let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, God, Send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. And now may the blessing of God Almighty be upon you this day and always, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Please rise for our closing hymn, an appropriate one for after eating at the Lord's table. Precious Lord, take my hand. It's number 800 in the Wonder, Love, and Praise book.
Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Now, if you'll gather around the ofrenda, we'll say a prayer before going into the church hall.
Yes, I was going to do the announcements.
Gather wherever you want, as close as you want. Usually people like to have the last row. Here there is no row, so you can move up. I'm going to wait just a couple more minutes because I have one more announcement that I need to make. First of all, I want to thank each and every one of you for honoring what we started a couple years ago, with Amanda and Maya and the tamale making that we've been doing, which you'll be able to have next Sunday. So I just want to thank you for that. I think it's so important that we remember our loved ones. And for many of us, they're still very much in our hearts. And that it can happen for years and years and years. When we talk about grieving or mourning, it doesn't just happen in a week, in a year. It happens a lifetime. So thank you for honoring this time and for taking the time to be able to hold your loved ones in prayer. And so let us pray. En el nombre del Padre, del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo. Amen. Spirit of life, we remember those we loved and loved us. We are grateful for the memories, and we are mindful that our love and relationships continue into the next life. Remind us that we too are mortal, and that the only enduring legacy we leave is a love that shines through our lives. In your boundless compassion, console us who remember them. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence, we may continue our course on earth until by your call, we are reunited through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Dios de nuestros antepasados, bendiga esta ofrenda que ha sido creada para los miembros de Saint Aidan's, en recuerdo y honor de sus seres queridos. Bendice los diversos elementos de la ofrenda que nos unan con nosotros, seres queridos. God of our ancestors, bless this ofrenda that has been created by the members of St. Aidan's in remembrance and honor of their loved ones. Bless the various elements of the ofrenda that unite us to our loved ones. We ask that you bless the flowers whose fragrance leads us to them. Bless the food that provides them nourishment. Bless the drink that refreshes them. Bless the mementos that assure our Lord that our loved ones remain in our hearts and in our minds. Bless the candles that light their path to us. Bless also the salt and water that are essential elements of life. Departed Christian souls, may you continue to rest this day in peace, in paradise with God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I want to remind you that on Wednesday of this week, if you haven't noticed this notice here, we'll be having a candlelight service for All Souls Day, El Día de los Muertos. So we invite you to come. It begins at 5:30, and it's not a very long service, but it's a time to remember our loved ones again by lighting a candle for each and one of those that you remember. So again, thank you, and we're ready to go partake of the goodies. Thank you.